హిందూ దేవాలయాలపై ఎక్కడ అసత్య ప్రచారం చేసినా ముందుంటా అన్నారు బీజేపీ ఎంపీ సుబ్రహ్మణ్య స్వామి. తిరుమల శ్రీవారిని దర్శించుకున్న అనంతరం ఆయన మాట్లాడుతూ దేశంలోని హిందూ దేవాలయాలు ఎక్కడ ప్రభుత్వ ఆధీనంలో ఉండకూడదన్నారు. బ్రాహ్మణులే వంశపారపర్యంగా అర్చకత్వానికి అర్హులు అనడం సరికాదని పురాణాల్లో విశ్వామిత్రుడు వాల్మీకులు బ్రాహ్మణులు కాకపోయినా ప్రచారం చేసిన ఋషులుగా ఆధ్యాత్మిక ప్రచారం చేశారని అన్నారు.
अल्ले वस्तान
you explain what happened today in Telugu, and then I'll take
over. Okay, na.
Padma Rao is our part of our team, and Satya Sabharwal.
Please stand.
Shall I take this off?
Yes.
With me are standing my colleagues, Mr. Padma Rao, who is looking after the our case here, and then Mr. Satya Sabharwal, who is the standing counsel for the TTD, and he lives, he is based and the standing counsel also in the Supreme Court. So he is helping me. I have been given special permission because I am an economist, not I am not a practicing lawyer. So under Section 32 of the Advocates Act, the court can give special permission. So I have a special permission, like in many other cases, including in the Supreme Court, to argue without being a lawyer. As a special case, of course, I've been law minister, so I should qualify. What happened in court today, I'm going to ask Padma Rao to explain first in Telugu, and then after that, I'll take over.
ఏదైతే ఆంధ్రజ్యోతి మీద 100 కోట్లకి డిఫమేషన్ సూట్ ఏదైతే వేసామండి 44/2021ది దాంట్లో ఏం జరిగింది అంటే సెప్టెంబర్ 24న ఆంధ్రజ్యోతి వాళ్ళు ఎవరైతే 5గురు డిఫెండెంట్స్ ఉన్నారో వాళ్ళ 5గురు మన వకాలత్ వేశారు అయితే సాధారణంగా 30 రోజుల లోపల రిటర్న్ స్టేట్మెంట్ వేయాలి ఆ రిటర్న్ స్టేట్మెంట్ 30 రోజుల్లో వేయలేదు తర్వాత దాన్ని ఎక్స్టెండ్ చేశారు తర్వాత లాస్ట్ డేట్ ఇచ్చినప్పుడు వాళ్ళకి ఫైన్ వేసి కాస్ట్ల మీద కట్టమని రిటర్న్ స్టేట్మెంట్ వేయమన్నారు సో ఇవాళ 90 రోజులు మాక్సిమం పీరియడ్ ఆ 90 రోజులు కూడా ఇవాళతో అయిపోయింది అంటే 24 డిసెంబర్కి అయిపోయింది అయితే ఇవాళ ఆంధ్రజ్యోతి తరఫు లాయర్ వచ్చి ఇవాళ సాయంత్రం లోపల వేస్తాను అని చెప్పారు అది వేస్తారా లేదా అనేది అప్పుడు తర్వాత తెలుస్తుంది దాన్ని బట్టి మా ఫర్దర్ కోర్స్ ఆఫ్ యాక్షన్ ఉంటుంది టీటీడి ఎగ్జిక్యూటివ్ ఆఫీసర్ మెయిన్ ప్లెయింటిఫ్ వారు సార్ని ఈ కేసు టేకప్ చేయమని అడిగారు అడ్వకేట్స్ యాక్ట్ 32 ప్రకారము ఎవరన్నా అదర్ దెన్ లాయర్ హూ ఇస్ నాట్ ఎన్రోల్డ్ ఇన్ ద బార్ తను అడ్వకేట్గా పెట్టుకునే అవకాశం ఉంది కాబట్టి వారు సార్కున్న పేరు వల్ల సార్కున్న నాలెడ్జ్ ఏదైతే ఉందో వారి ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ని ఎందుకంటే సార్ సభానాయకం కేసులో అలాంటి సెన్సేషనల్ జడ్జిమెంట్స్లో సుప్రీంకోర్టు ఫేవరబుల్ ఆర్డర్స్ తెచ్చారు కాబట్టి మొత్తం ఈ ఎండోమెంట్ సిస్టమ్ మీద వీటి మీద సార్కున్న అవగాహన దృష్ట్యా సార్ని వారు రిక్వెస్ట్ చేయడం జరిగింది ఈవో గారు టీటీడీ వాళ్ళు దానివల్ల సార్ టీటీడీ తరఫున వారు కూడా స్వామివారి భక్తులు కాబట్టి వారి పూర్వీకుల నుంచి ఈ కేసుని టేకప్ చేశారు
ది అలిగేషన్ మేడ్ బై ఆంధ్రజ్యోతి వాజ్ ద మోస్ట్ డిస్పికబుల్ అలిగేషన్ పాసిబుల్ దే పుట్ ఆన్ దేర్ ఫ్రంట్ పేజ్ సేయింగ్ ఎ పిక్చర్ of Jesus Christ is now enclosed in the website of TTD. That was completely false. In a separate appearance I made before the High Court, in a public interest litigation, the court summoned the DGP to ask whether they have done any investigation about Jesus Christ's photo, yeah, Yesu as he is called here, in the TTD website. And he has in writing given to the High Court that no such proof was given by anybody, and we found nothing in any of the previous notings of the TTD in their website. So it's a completely false, it's a lie, and it was only meant to provoke the Hindu people to rise against the Jagan government's nomination to the TTD. Also falsehood was that TTD chairman Subba Reddy is a Christian, which is rubbish. I've known him for years. He has come with me to Tirupati many times, or his wife is a Christian. I don't know why this campaign is being done, but Andhra Jyoti's writings, editorials show that they seem to have a special liking for Chandrababu Naidu. So maybe that influence is there, I can't say. But in this case, they have already lost in the High Court. And in the High Court, it was decided, and now a charge sheet has been filed and a trial is going to start to punish them under the hate speech laws, such as 153A and 295A, which carry sentences which go over 10 years. So therefore, Andhra Jyoti, we have said, should A, apologize, and B, pay 100 crores as damages, for which stamp duty of 1 crore has been paid by the TTD. And so my view is that there is no escape for Andhra Jyoti. They should not have done this. This is a country, we are 80% Hindu. We are proud that we have a Hindu legacy, but we also have a tradition of looking after other religions without exploiting them. The Zoroastrians are an example, the Jews are another example. And now in modern India, Christians and Muslims are also people who have freedom to practice their religion, and we'll not interfere as long as the constitution of India is respected. So this is the state. Today the judge has told, the honorable judge has said that at 5 o'clock, if they have not filed the rejoinder, they did not file the rejoinder, even though, excuse me, they didn't write their written statement in reply to our written statement. But despite the fact that the law says they must do it within 90 days, within 30 days, they didn't do it within 30 days. Then the court gave them another extension of time, and that is the maximum provided under the law of 90 days. And they still have not. But today, they are saying that they will file. And at 5 o'clock, the judge, the honorable judge, said that if they don't file by 5 o'clock today, then the petition we have given saying that the matter can now proceed without their challenging any of our facts. Because if you don't file a written statement, a counter-written statement, that means you are accepting all our facts. And that means the defeat of Andhra Jyoti will happen in a very short time. And how they can pay 100 crores, I don't know. But they can easily apologize, and therefore it's up to them. In the interest of press freedom, it requires that when you are making an allegation of this kind, the press freedom is laid down that you will give the other side an opportunity to reply, which they did not do. They did not ask TTD, have you put this on the on your website, which the press council says is a must. So they violated every law possible. It's the most reckless presentation, which fortunately, because we intervened and people like me took it up, the Hindus then felt satisfied that we will bring the truth out and we'll solve this according to the truth.
In spite of defamation, is there any criminal conspiracy or criminal act?
That is there in the writ petition, which has now been directed to the police, and they have registered not only an FIR, but they have now given to the court a charge sheet. So a trial will start on that. On conspiracy and so on.
TTD Pradhan Archaka Ramandeep Sitharu recently tagged to you about Vamsa Anuvanshika Archakatvam.
He tagged hereditary Archakas.
Not implicated in
TTD. Not implementing hereditary Archaka in TTD, sir.
But that's another subject.
Tagged to you, sir.
Ramandeep Sitharu tagged. You mean you finished with the subject now?
No, sir. One more thing, sir. On that day, which newspaper he carried, they also printed the TTD version also. And the second day, TTD...
Before, what? I don't know, because it's a... We have not seen it. But I am saying that before printing it, they should have asked. After printing it, they published their rebuttal. That is not acceptable.
There is a TTD version also.
No, it may be. But question is, why before printing it, you didn't ask? And this was certainly not a... The TTD was not asked in advance. I have checked that.
Sir, government marde TTD case no any case. Gatamlo Ramanadeep Sitharu adhe vidhanga JSI Reddy meedi kuda idu vandako ide paruna
sandarbha. What he is saying is that whenever the government is changing, they are withdrawing the defamation suits. So we cannot answer that question.
It was happened earlier, sir. It was happened earlier.
No, may have happened earlier, but this is not the government's responsibility. It is I who filed it, and I never withdraw any case.
And you are going to try for a TTD autonomous, sir?
No, that's a separate question. You see, that is, I have already a petition pending where the Chief Minister, Mr. Jagan, has accepted one of the prayers, which is that the accounts of the TTD will be audited by CAG and not by the government. During Chandrababu Naidu's period and previous, the government used to do the audit.
So that's not implementing now also?
No, they have,
it's implemented.
It is implemented as far as law is concerned, and the first year is starting now. So I can't say that it's a big job. CAG taking all 5 years, past 5 years. I have asked for 5 years, past 5 years. Then we'll know what Chandrababu Naidu had been doing.
Do you attend for every adjournment?
You see, question is, there have not been many adjournments.
COVID.
When COVID issue was there, we did not come. When we filed it, I was here.
Virtual conference.
We had a virtual conference where I appeared to say why I should be permitted to represent the TTD, even though I have not got a law degree, and that was accepted online. And now I've come here in the first hearing. This is the first hearing.
Physical.
I will be throughout.
Issues filming.
I will go right to the end. I always do like that. I don't get in, or if I get in, it's all the way.
We frequently will meet, that's why.
You will meet, yes. Maybe I'll give you the lunch after the whole thing is over. நான் போனேன் என்ன சொல்வேன், நீ பிராமணர், நீங்கள் உங்களுக்கெல்லாம் ஓட்டு கொடுக்க முடியாது,
இப்போ
அதெல்லாம் சொல்வேன். ஒரு வாட்டி நான் மதுரை தொகுதியிலேருந்து ஜெயித்தேன். எல்லோரையும் தோக்கடிச்சு மதுரையில் பிராமணர் எப்பயும் ஜெயிக்கவே இல்லை. எல்லாம் பிரச்சாரம் பேருக்கும் நான் ஜெயித்தேன். ஆனால் இந்த திராவிட முன்னேற்ற கழகம், திராவிட கழகம், இவாளோட மூளை எப்பயும் சரியாக இவளை காலி பண்ணணும். அப்போ தான் தமிழ்நாட்டுக்கு விடுதலை கிடைக்கும். தேவஸ்தானம் அது என்னோட தனிப்பட்ட கேஸ் இருக்கு, அது 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 நடக்கட்டும், அதை நான் வந்து உங்களுக்கு கட்டாயமாக செய்தி
கொடுக்குறேன்.
கோயிலெலாம் நான் பண்ணுறேன். இப்போ இந்த அர்ச்சகா இஷ்யூ சுப்ரீம் கோர்ட்டில் இருக்குது, அது வரப்போகுது இப்போது. அதே மாதிரி சபாநாயகர் கோயிலை அடுத்து பற்றி நான் வந்து இப்போ சுப்ரீம் கோர்ட்டில் போய் வாதம் பண்ணி அதை விடுதலை பண்ணி கொடுத்தேன். இப்போ தீட்சிதா இருக்க கையில் தான் இருக்குது. இந்த கோயில் எந்த கோயிலும் சுப்ரீம் கோர்ட் ஜட்ஜ்மெண்ட் இருக்குது வந்து, அதை வந்து அரசாங்கம் ஒரு தவறை வந்து சரியாக்கிறதுக்கு ஒரு சில மாதத்துக்கு சில ரெண்டு மூணு வருஷத்துக்காக அந்த அந்த ஃபைனான்ஸ் டிபார்ட்மெண்ட்டை எடுத்துக்கலாம், ஆனால் கோயில் எடுத்துக்க முடியாது. ஆனால் அதை மீறி வாழலாம் பண்ணுறா. சட்டத்தை பற்றி வாழ் கவலையே கிடையாது. சினிமாக்காரன்னா இந்த சினிமாக்காரனுக்குலாம் ஒன்றும் புரியாது சட்டம். அதனால் இந்த சட்டத்தை வந்து நான் இப்போது ஒரு ஒரு கேஸ்க்காக வந்து சுப்ரீம் கோர்ட் முதல்லே முடிவு பண்ணியாச்சு. அதை இங்கே வந்து அமல் பண்ணணும் பண்ணுறதுக்கு அவசியமாயிடுது. டைம் தான். எல்லா கோயிலும் 4 லட்சம் கோயில் இருக்குது இந்தியா முழுக்க. அதை இப்போ இந்த எங்கள் நம்ம கட்சியோட கவர்மெண்ட் உத்தரகாண்டில் வந்து எல்லா கோயிலும் எடுத்துட்டா நான் கேஸ் போட்டேன். இப்போ என்ன பயந்த இவாள்லாம் வாங்கிட்டா வாபிஸ் இப்போ திருப்பி எனக்கு ஏபியாவில் நான் ஆல்ரெடி பண்ணி ஆரம்பிச்சுட்டேன். முதல்ல கோல்ட் பிளேட்டிங்காக வந்தது திருப்பதியை, அதுக்கான கேஸில் வந்து ஜெயித்தேன். கோல்ட் பிளேட்டிங் பண்ண அப்புறம் பண்ண முடியல. அதே மாதிரி இதுலேயும் இந்த திருப்பதியை வந்து கவர்மெண்ட் கையிலேருந்து வெளியில் எடுக்கணும்னு இந்த கேஸ் போட்டிருக்கேன். அதில் இந்த ஒரு பாதியை ஒத்துட்டார் முதலமைச்சர். இதை சிஏஜி ஆடிட்டிங் நடக்கணும், கவர்மெண்ட் ஆடிட்டிங் நடக்கக்கூடாது, அவர் ஒத்துட்டார். அதை இப்போ அதை விடுதலை செய்யறதுக்காக அதை இதுவரையும் டேட் வரவில்லை. அதனால நான் அது வாதம்
பண்ணுறேன்.
இது நான் கவனிக்கிறேன் சார். அங்கே தமிழ்நாட்டில் போய் ஒரு 4-5 நாள் தங்கினதுக்கப்புறம் தான் சொல்ல முடியும். ஆனால் வந்து இவத்துக்கு முன்னால் இருந்த அதிமுகவும் மோசம், அதுக்கு முன்னால் இருந்த கருணாநிதியும் மகா மோசம், இவர் மகா மோசமா இல்லையா கொஞ்ச நாளுக்கு அப்புறம் கேளுங்க
சார். சார் சார் அபார்ட் ஃப்ரம் திஸ் சார், ஜஸ்ட் சார், சுவாமி சார் வில் ஸ்டாண்ட் ஃபார் திஸ் கேஸ் ஓன்லி இன் பிஹாஃப் ஆன் பிஹாஃப் ஆஃப் டிடிடி ஆர் வில் கண்டினியூ
எனி இன்ஜஸ்டிஸ் ஐ எம் ரெடி டு ஸ்டாண்ட் ஃபார்.
ஸோ ஹெரிடிட்ரி அர்ச்சகாஸ் ஃப்ரீக்வெண்ட்லி சேயிங் தட் டிடிடி டூயிங் இன்ஜஸ்டிஸ்,
தே ஹவ் நாட் கிவன் மீ எனி பெட்டிஷன். The one petition came when
Ramana
Diksha, I got him reinstated.
Tweeted for you.
He may have tweeted, for I don't can't take by tweet. I have what 10.7 million followers. Right. If they all start tweeting with me, then I mean I can't be a member of parliament, I can't be even an Indian citizen, I'll have to run away.
So being a Hindu legendary,
yes.
So what is your comment on hereditary archakas?
I believe anybody who is educated in Sanskrit and knows and passes an exam, he is a qualified archaka. It doesn't matter whether it's hereditary or not hereditary, it doesn't matter if he's a Brahmin or a non-Brahmin. It only, in fact, whoever is educated in our thing, he becomes a Brahmin. According to Lord Krishna in Gita, a Brahmin is not born. He is either, he must be a Jnani, a Tyagi, and a Sahasi, Dairyam. If 3 qualities you have, you are a Brahmin. So Vishwamitra was born in a Kshatriya family, but he became a Maharishi because he had these 3. Vedavyasa, mother was a fisherwoman. But he became a Maharishi because of these 3 qualities. So did scheduled caste Valmiki. He also became a Maharishi. Well, his parents were scheduled caste, but he was not. He was
a Brahmin. There is no certification for huh?
Yeah.
Please continue. Okay. Please continue, sir. TTD not followed RTA Act.
All these questions, all these questions you cannot ask me. At this moment, I'm on this. You call me for a separate press club conference. There I will answer any question you want.
You will agree to come to press club? Yes,
I will agree to come. But there
will be
a
lot of policemen also.
Number அண்ணா அண்ணா பாஸ்ரண்ணா கேமரா பைக்க தட்டு வேறு